Alright, hello Washington Eagles. It is Wednesday, April 22nd, and we are subtracting with larger numbers, and yes, we're going to be regrouping, because that's just the way it goes. Let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I kind of like to do is just kind of look at my problem. I don't see a problem 9 minus 2. You can take 2 out of 9. But our 4 is smaller than our 9, so we're going to have to regroup there. And so, let's get started. All right, if we have 9, and we take away 2, it is 7. Now, here we run into a problem. We cannot take 9 out of 4. There's not enough, so we have to borrow. We've got to borrow from the Hensler's place. So that becomes a 5, and the 4 becomes a 14. Now, we can subtract 14 minus 9. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that is 5. And 5 minus 1 is 4. Let's add. Okay, 457 plus 192. Remember, we can check by adding. So 7, 8, 9. Oh my God, 7, 8, 9. Poor 9. 5 plus 9, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 1, 4, 5 plus 1 is 6, plus 1 is, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6. So our answer is 649. Are we correct? We are, 649. So 649 minus 192 is 457. Let's do another one. All right, right off the bat, we're going to have to borrow because you can't take 7 out of 3. So we're going to borrow from the tens place. That becomes a 7, and that becomes a 13. So now we can subtract 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 13 minus 7 is 6. 7 minus 6 is 1. And 7 minus 2 is 5. So, let's check by adding. So, we're going to work this out. So, 516 plus 267. Sorry, it's so small. That's what it goes sometimes. So, 6 plus 7. So, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 7. 783. 783. All right, rock on, friends. Let's keep it moving. All right, let's see if we can. Ooh, we did. I said, let me see if I can find one where we just keep on borrowing. Read my mind. All right, 846 minus 59. Okay, here we go. We gotta borrow from the ones and the tens, and it's gonna be busy. All right, so we're gonna take this nice and slow, okay? Let's start. So, we can't take 9 out of 6, so we have to borrow. This becomes a 3, this becomes a 16. So now we can subtract 16 minus 9. So 6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 7. Now, 3 minus 5. We can't do it. We cannot take 5 out of 3. There is not enough. So now we're going to have to borrow again from the hundreds place. Okay? So the 8 becomes a 7. And this becomes a 13. Can we subtract 13 minus 5? We can. We can subtract 13 minus 5. So 3, 4, 5 is 8. And 7 minus 0 is 7. Can we check by adding? Of course we can check by adding. 787 plus 59. So it's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 7, 8. 846 846. Okay? Let's try another one. All right, $7.12 minus $5.94. Okay, nice and slow. Here we go. Still can't do it. But we can. Let's keep it. Let's go. All right. So we cannot take 4 out of 2. So we got to borrow. So this becomes a 0, and that becomes a 12. So now we can subtract 12 minus 4. 2, 3, 4, which is 8. You cannot take 9 out of 0. You just can't do it. You got to borrow. This is going to become a 6, and that is going to become a 10. So 10 minus 9 is what? 6 minus 5 is 1. So 7, 12 minus 5, 94 is 118. Right, I forgot the decimal. Holy animals. And I forgot our dollar sign. That makes a difference, doesn't it? So $7.12 minus $5.94 is $1.18. All right. Check by adding? Yeah, why not? Yeah, why not? All right, we're going to add. 8 plus 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 9, 10, 11. Drop down that decimal. 5, 6, 7. Where's your money sign? Oh, there it is. $7.12. $7.12. All right, let's rock on. This is the old-fashioned way of subtracting. Tomorrow, I may show an... Well, I don't know if I'll do that. I haven't decided about tomorrow just yet. We'll see. Let's do one more, and then I want you to do a couple on your own. $745 minus... 159. We're doing a lot of borrowing. This is great practice for you, okay? Remember, you cannot flip any numbers. Can't do it. So, let's borrow, because you cannot take 9 out of 5. You can't. It can't happen. So, that becomes a 3, and that becomes a 15. So, can we subtract 9 out of 15? Yeah, we can take 9 out of 15, so 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 6. Holy animals. Oh, a 3 and a 5. Do not flip those numbers. Do not do it. It's not worth it. Okay? You cannot take 5 out of 3. So we're going to borrow 6. And that becomes a 13. So 13 minus 5, 3, 4, 5 is 8. 6 minus 1 is 5. 586. So 745 minus 159 is 586. 586 plus 159. 9 plus 5, 9 plus 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 8 plus 1 is 9. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 5, 6, 7, 745, 745. Add or subtract, counting however you can. I mean, I know I've seen my students just add and subtract differently using their fingers, so I just do it the way that I learned how. So whatever works for you, works for you. We're going to do one more, and then let's do 958. Minus 79. Okay. If we've done this one before already, then sorry. I guess you just get lucky that way. Because I'm trying to think, did we do this one? I do not know. Alright, so 8 minus 9. I know. That becomes 18. 8, 9. Because if you knew 9 times 9 plus 9 is 18. So you should know that. All right. 4 minus 7. I know. It becomes an 8. That becomes 14. That is another double fact. 14 minus 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. Because 7 plus 7 is 14. 8 minus 0. 8. Let's check. Yeah, we didn't do that one because I think I would have gone, oh yeah. 18 minus 9 would be 9. So I would have recognized the double facts. Okay, 879 plus 79. Well, 9 plus 9 is 18. You all should know that. 7 plus 7 is 14. Plus 1 is 15. 8 plus 1 is 9. 958. Okay. All right. Tomorrow, I will probably do some more subtraction. I haven't quite decided about that, but